Max. It's our first stop.
The old Grinchy Claus hissed, and he climbed to the roof, empty bags in his fist. He'd slide down the chimney, a rather tight pinch. But if Santa could do it, then so could the Grinch.
He's planning a double twisting interrupted 4x2.5 with a combo tuck and pike. High degree of difficulty.
He got stuck only once, for a moment or two.
Blasted water weight goes right to my hips.
Then he stuck his head out of the fireplace flue.
A little more stealth, please.
Were the little hoo stockings all hung in a row?
The stockings,
he grinned,
are the first thing to go. Okay, fellas. Chow time.
Heard a small sound like the coo of a dove.
Excuse me.
The Grinch had been caught by this tiny hoo daughter who'd got out of bed for a cup of cold water.
Santa Claus, what are you doing with our tree?
But you know, that old Grinch was so smart and so slick. He thought up a lie, and he thought it up quick.
My sweet little dot.
The fake Santa Claus lied.
There's a light on this tree that won't blink on one side. So I'm taking it home to my workshop, my dear. I'll fix it up there, and I'll bring it back here.
Santa, what's Christmas really about?
Vengeance! Presents. I suppose.
I was afraid of that.
And his fib fooled the child. Then he patted her head, and he got her a drink, and he sent her to bed.
Santa?
What?
Don't forget the Grinch. I know he's mean and hairy and smelly. His hands might be cold and clammy. But I think he's actually kind of sweet.
Sweet? You don't think he's sweet?
Merry Christmas, Santa.
And when Cindy Lou went up with her cup...
Nice kid. Bad judge of character.
He went to the chimney and stuffed the tree up.